สวัสดีค่ะ Now come to part number 2 to determine the heat of reaction and we're gonna do 3 parts to find out what is delta H1, delta H2 and delta H3. Remember that we need the heat capacity from part 1 for the calculation. Part 2, 2.1, we're gonna find out heat of dissolution of sodium hydroxide in a solid form, or delta H1. So we need a solid sodium hydroxide. We have to weigh it around 1 gram and then record the exact weight, and need some water. Here is how to do the experiment. We need a calorimeter again. Add 50 milliliters of water into the beaker and then cover it up and record the temperature, and this would be your TI or initial temperature, and we got the result like this. TI would be 31 degrees Celsius, and the mass of this water would be 50 grams. Next, we're gonna add sodium hydroxide that we weighed out already into the calorimeter, and then we have to stir it continuously until all the sodium hydroxide dissolve, and look at the temperature change. Keep going. And you will start to see the temperature increases from 31 before, now it's going up until we reach the highest temperature like this. Okay, and we record the final temp as TF, and here is your result. Final temperature of this reaction is 35 degrees Celsius, and the weight of sodium hydroxide is 0.99 gram. Once you get the result, we're gonna calculate delta H1 for this reaction. Delta H1 is for this reaction, which is for sodium hydroxide 1 mole. Now, the heat that transfer between the reaction and the solution in calorimeter is like this. The heat of this reaction is delta H1. Here in a negative sign, equal to mass of the solution times specific heat times difference of temperature plus heat capacity of calorimeter times difference of temperature T final minus T initial. And these are your result: T initial, T final, and mass of the solution, or in this one it's water and surrounding. Remember, the number that you got from this calculation is the heat released by the reaction. Heat released because you have seen the temperature of the water or your solution increases. The reaction release heat to the solution. Heat released by this reaction is only come from this amount of sodium hydroxide. Use stoichiometry to get delta H in joule per mole of sodium hydroxide, and that would be delta H for this reaction. Okay. Then move on to part 2. Heat of reaction between sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid, both
in the solution form. This will be our delta H2. So the solution is 1 molar sodium hydroxide 25 milliliter and 1 molar hydrochloric acid 25 milliliter. We do the experiment by adding 25 milliliter of hydrochloric acid into the beaker in calorimeter first. And record this initial temp to be our Ti. And this is the result. Ti is 31 degrees Celsius. Number 2, add 25 milliliter of sodium hydroxide solution into calorimeter. And stir the mixture continuously. The temperature already increases. And then wait until you reach the highest temperature and record your T final. The T final here is 36.5 degrees Celsius. Once we've got T final, we do the same similar calculation. Now the heat released from the reaction, delta H2, again equal to the heat absorbed by solution plus calorimeter. M now is the total mass of the solution, total mass of the mixture. We have 25 ml of sodium hydroxide and 25 milliliter of hydrochloric acid. The total mass will be for 50 milliliter of solution. So M here is again 50 gram. Just approximate the density of the mixed solution to be 1 gram per milliliter. Ti 31 degrees Celsius, Tf 36.5 degrees Celsius. Again, the H2 calculated from this formula is for this amount of substance only. You need to find out delta H2 for 1 mole of sodium hydroxide. Next, move on to 2.3. The heat of reaction between sodium hydroxide now in the solid form and hydrochloric acid solution, delta H3. This is going to be our step one in the introduction. Same thing, weight around 1 gram of sodium hydroxide and use 50 milliliter of hydrochloric acid. Similar method, add the hydrochloric acid solution first into the calorimeter, use 50 milliliter, and of course record the initial temp, and you get the initial temp as 30.5 degrees Celsius. Mass, as I told you, gonna be the mass of 50 milliliter hydrochloric acid. Approximate density of hydrochloric acid solution here also to be 1 gram per milliliter because we use water as a solvent. And then we add the solid sodium hydroxide into the calorimeter. Of course, we have to stir the mixture continuously until all the sodium hydroxide reacted. And again, same thing, record the final temperature or Tf. And this is your result. Again, Tf 40.2 degrees Celsius with the mass of sodium hydroxide 1.03 gram. Put everything into calculation. Same pattern. The heat release from the reaction goes into the solution and calorimeter. Ti 30.5 degrees Celsius, Tf 40.2 degrees Celsius, mass of hydrochloric acid solution 50 gram. Delta H3 here is for this amount of sodium hydroxide and this amount of hydrochloric acid. Find out what is delta H3 in joule per mole of sodium hydroxide. So now we finish all the experiment. We've got the value of delta H1, delta H2, and delta H3. Compare this value to the standard values that calculated from this delta H of reaction, from delta H of formation of substances. The delta HF of substances are given to you in the manual in table 6.1. We're gonna compare our experimental result, delta H1, to this calculated from the formula here. In table 6.1, the delta HF that are given to you are in the form of sodium ion and hydroxide ion, we can break this to be in ion form and also sodium chloride in the ion form as well. So these two reactions will change slightly like this, so that you can use the delta HF from table 6.1 in the manual to calculate for the result. And also in your report, discuss about your result in which you prove the Hess's law concept. Delta H1 plus delta H2, is it equal to delta H3? Or approximate the same, approximately the same. Okay, ค่ะ. Finish your report and upload to the folder that I set it up for you, นะคะ. สวัสดีค่ะ.